Tata Power Safety Pledge. We, the employees of Tata Power, firmly believe that all injuries are preventable and all operating exposures can be safeguarded. We wholeheartedly accept that working safely is everybody's responsibility and a condition of employment. We shall strictly adhere to Tata Power safety standards and procedures for the prevention of all types of incidents. We shall put all our best efforts to achieve our safety vision to be a leader in safety excellence in the global power and energy business. We solemnly affirm that we will dedicate ourselves to the cause of safety in the interest of self, our family, organization, society, and nation at large. Thank you. Good morning all. Tata Power welcomes you to this safety training session. Today we are going to do trenching job and we are here to walk you through the safety measures which need to be taken care of during the job. First, we need to check basic PPEs. Helmet should be of proper ISI mark and the locking arrangement should be proper and chin strip should be worn properly. Then safety goggles should be of proper condition. There should be reflective jacket. Hand gloves should be in proper condition. It should be of cotton for normal use and rubber for water use. Then safety shoes should be in proper condition and it should be worn only with socks. Full sleeve cotton clothing, shirt and pants should be there and all things should be worn before conducting toolbox talk. After this, toolbox talk is conducted. In toolbox talk, first thing we have to do is check workman certification. Every worker should be TPSDI certified. Now tools inspection is done. For trenching work, we need to first check the crowbar. The crowbar should be insulated and tested as well. And the gamela being used should be of plastic. Now we will talk about hazards involved in the job. The first thing is material unloading. In case of trenching, the material being unloaded is gunny bags, barricades, drums and walkways. In this case, we need to park the vehicle properly so that it does not hamper the traffic. The second thing is the vehicle should be parked properly and the choke should be applied and the handbrake should also be applied to the vehicle. The persons unloading the material should not be less than two. Now proper safety signages should be on display and traffic wardens should be there to control the traffic. Now the second thing which involves hazards is trial pit. In case of trial pit, the area to be excavated should be properly marked by line. The area should be checked by cable avoidance tool to check whether there is any underground utility or not. The third thing is the area to be excavated should be properly barricaded. Barricades should be properly placed with gunny bags and drums should be filled with proper material. Paver stones should be stacked properly so that minimum damage occurs. The excavated earth should be kept at least 1 meter away from the trench. Proper ladders should be kept to provide proper ingress and egress at every 30 meter inside the trench. If water is found inside the trench, it should be immediately removed using water pump. Proper walkways with handrails should be provided to cross the trench or anywhere, any shop or any structure of external stakeholders is found. Standard display signages should be placed at the interval of every 30 meters. Existing structures such as trees, light poles, where there is a danger of falling those things in case of excavation should be properly supported using different methods. Backfilling. The first thing we have to do is to check that above cables proper safety tiles has been placed or not. Only fill earth inside the trench. No metal or concrete debris should be filled inside the trench. Fill 100 mm or 4 inch above the surface of the earth, as when vehicular movement occurs, the earth which we have filled tends to settle. All extra debris should be removed. Now, area cleaning. All materials such as barricades, drums, gunny bags and extra debris should be removed as immediately as possible so that it does not cause any hindrance to the traffic or the people moving on the road. Working at night. Standard lighting arrangement should be made. Only 30 milliampere ELCB is allowed on the site. Emergency. In case of emergency, following things should be kept into mind. Whistle with supervisor. It should be blown 3 times in case of emergency. Thank you all, and we hope that you will have safe day today. Please remember one thing, that you have someone waiting for you at home. Thank you.